trying to find rhythm in movement of the crowd, finding the origins of fiction, because the city is a fiction. The sky blue and the forest green become the roman, the novel, which becomes abstraction. Godard states, it's just a note of intention. That doesn't make a melody, but Rome wasn't built in a day. The first showing of the film that was to celebrate the 500 years of Lausanne's founding was at the Swiss Cinematheque in 1981, but the book about its making, his letter to Freddie Walsh, came out in 2001. No one liked the film. Unlike Ricci, something called La Dérive comes into focus. They turn left. Poetry as drift, as presentation, not representation. Assembling fragments, phrases, arranged together equals syntax. Not exactly fiction, not exactly nonfiction. Forest, mountain, lake, or sea, perhaps. In the fiction of area, memory is everywhere. Area of fiction, it's the name of the book, it's also the character area, says at the book's close, these words in which honey was tenderly mingled with venom, don't forget, don't forget. Dear Stacy, looking through another book by Emmanuel Bocard and Juliet Valerie, Lyrical Meditator poem, A Private Eye, Thomas Mobius is the eye in the story. It is a story, a noir, black and white photo text work. Flipping pages, there you are. Or there is you. Dear Stacy, Osip Mandelstam, in his major essay, Talking About Dante, means to say that a composition is formed not from heaping up of particulars, but in consequence of the fact that one detail after another is torn away from the object, leaves it, flutters out, is packed away from the system. Whereas in his addenda to Journey to Armenia, he says, and this is substantively how Card writes about writing, prose which corresponds to reality, no matter how expressly and minutely, no matter how efficiently and faithfully, is always a broken series, a broken sign of the unbroken continuum. Giorgio Agamben writes in his elegant preface to Infancy and History, every written work can be regarded as the prologue, or rather the broken cast of a work never penned and destined to remain so, because later works, which in turn will be the prologues, the molds for other absent works, represent only set sketches or death masks. The absent work thereby constitutes the counterfeit of a book which cannot be written. In various of his texts, novels, poems, chronicles, Card writes about this particular absence in terms of his old friend, the archaeologist Montalbon, who is forever trying to piece together shards of a fresco that once existed and now it's just in his mind or in mind's eye, the continuum is not about origins, but about rhyming space-time, as in timelessness, the ever-present. Just spacey, the more I reread area, the more of a dream I find myself in. In each section, more a sense of smell, touch, as though touching each letter, as in the manual quote cards, how I wrote one, a chronicle. I learned how to write with the help of an alphabet whose letters, cut out of heavy cardboard, were painted with red varnish. From one letter to the next, red was not exactly the same. I learned to trace each letter by walking my index finger over the smooth surface. From the same book, how I wrote, sitting at my long table, first published in 1981. And in the beginning of area, we see him sitting today at my long table. As Wittgenstein has written, we are asleep, our life is a dream, but we wake up sometimes just enough to know that we are dreaming. I just saw on YouTube a poem I don't think we've seen from Immanuel Bocard, Je ne sais pas si Fernando Pessoa et Vermont Rudens existait, read by him on May 10th, 2010, with a photo. I don't know whether Fernando Pessoa has ever existed. Who has? Thank you.